profit, there are two aids, valuation of goodwill and valuation of shares. Now, first of all, we will go to the goodwill. Goodwill term we are listening from the very first day of our work in our commerce area, that is from the junior college onwards. Goodwill is nothing but what intangible asset. It is a reputation of the business. So many terms and definitions are there, but goodwill is difficult to define and easy to explain. So there are various methods for calculation of goodwill, and we also have learned in the case of partnership firm. Even at the 12th level also, we in junior college, we have studied about the valuation of goodwill. So goodwill is something which enables the proprietors to earn more profit in future, as well as in a particular industry where a company earns more than their competitors. Definitely we can say that that company is a reputed firm or having a great potentiality to earn a good revenue or good profit. So goodwill is nothing but one excess of the cost of some kind. It is defined as a goodwill is the excess of the cost of an acquired entity over the date of the amount assigned to assets acquired and liability assumed. So for example, if the company's total business valuation is say for example 10 crore, but the purchaser, the company who purchased that business may pay 11 crore rupees. So 1 crore rupees extra. That is nothing but what? Goodwill. Why they are paying 1 crore rupees extra? Because that company may have having good potentiality to earn the profit as compared to the competitor, or there may be a possibility of good profit potentiality, or sometimes they get the ready-made business and therefore they are willing to pay extra amount. Sometimes the goodwill is explained as fair value of net assets that were not on the books of the acquired enterprises. Very philosophical explanation of the goodwill. So, in same case in our example, that if the business is valued, net business is valued at 10 crore rupees and the purchasing company is paying 11 crore rupees, means the assets which is not on the date of the acquisition in the financial book, that is nothing but what? Goodwill. The very important definitions which is defined by some experts is the fair value of the expected synergies from combining the acquiring enterprise and acquired enterprise net assets and business. So there are some factors which determine the company's future profitability, future earnings, reputation, the credentiality in the capital market, and so many factors are there. If their synergetic effect is nothing but what ultimately comes in the valuation of goodwill. So goodwill is a something extra assets which is not maybe recorded in the financial book, but and also definitely it is intangible and something which gives extra to the business as compared to the other competitors. So the some features of the goodwill are they are intangible in nature, fluctuation, the value fluctuate according to the ups and downs of the firm. There is no separate realization, you cannot sell the goodwill separately. As soon as you sell the entire business, that time only you will get the realization of goodwill, otherwise not. If the business is purchased from the vendor and some amount is paid extra, say for example goodwill, then goodwill should be amortized in the financial book of the company. So there are subjective valuation for the goodwill. Some elements are there, various types of goodwill. So there are two types of goodwill. One is a purchase goodwill and another one is a non-purchase or sale-generated goodwill. There are lot of, in India it is not possible to record the sale-generated goodwill. Some company may, according to the present value of the future earnings, that factor they may value the goodwill and they may record it in the financial book, but that is not allowed. But in Indian accounting standards allows the purchase goodwill to be recorded in the books, but it is to be amortized over the period of year. Now, various factors are creating the goodwill. So for example, the managerial competence, strong recorded in the book only when some consideration in money or money's worth is paid for. Means Indian accounting standard only allows the goodwill to be recorded in the financial books if it is only purchased. That means while purchasing of the assets, if you have paid any extra amount, then only you can record the goodwill in the financial books. On the other hand, accounting standard 14, which deals with the amalgamation of the companies, it states that if the company's purchase consideration is more than the net asset value of the business, then only goodwill is to be recorded. In the case of accounting standard 21, which is related to the consolidated financial statement, in our earlier lecture we have studied about the consolidated financial statement where the holding company made major investment in the subsidiary company. At the time of the consolidation, if the carrying cost of the investment, very important, if the carrying cost of the investment under the fourth working on cost of control, if the carrying cost of the investment is more than the, say for example, the paid up value of the investment, then definitely you will get the capital reserve, otherwise the goodwill. Means for example, you paid more than the carrying amount, definitely the goodwill will be there and that you have to disclose under the fixed assets. And the last is accounting standard 26, which is related to the internally generated goodwill. That should not be recognized as an asset. That is a different part. Now, sir will explain how to compute the goodwill with the help of future maintainable profits and the various techniques. So many techniques are there to calculate the goodwill. I request the Nelson sir of your subject teacher and he will continue the further discussion in 2-3 lectures. Thank you.
Start.
So, hello students. So, today we are meeting after a long time because of lockdown. So, today as Magnable sir has already told that we are going to start with the new topic in financial accounting, that is valuation of business. So, I hope you all are keeping well and all are safe. So, with that, we will start with the new topic in financial accounting, that is valuation of business. So, we will first understand what is valuation of business and then we will talk about different parts of it. So, what is the valuation? So, first we need to understand, when we are talking about valuation, first thing we need to understand is what is value. So, what is value? Value is estimated worth of an asset. So, when we have any asset in our position, what is the value of it? It is an estimated worth. What is worth? What is the benefit and rights? What are the benefits and rights we received from holding the asset? That is called as value of that asset. That is called the worth of that asset. That is called the value of that asset. So when we are talking about valuation, what is valuation? Valuation is the assessment. Assessment of finding out the worth. Assessment of finding the correct worth of an asset. So when we do the valuation of any asset, what we are doing here? Assessing or finding the correct worth of that asset. What is the worth of that asset? What is worth? Worth means the benefit, monetary benefits and the rights which we are receiving because of the purchase of that asset. So that is called as valuation. So what we are doing? We are doing the assessment. Assessment of what? Finding out the worth. So here what we are doing? Valuation. We are doing the assessment to find out the worth of what? Worth of business. So that is why we are calling it as valuation of business. What is business? Is an entity, economic entity established to earn some profit in the industry or in the market. So this economic entity we have established and we are doing some assessment to finding out what is the value of our business which we have set up. So when we are doing the valuation of business, what is the value of business? What is the value of business? We go to the financial statements. The financial statement of a business. So what we have to, there are one statement called as balance sheet. Balance sheet. What? Balance sheet gives us, balance sheet will show us assets listed there, what was the liability. So by simple way, you can get the value of business is equal to assets minus liability. That is called as net asset. So if you take the totals of all the assets minus all the liabilities which you need to pay, you will get net assets of your business. That is called as the value of your business. What is the value of your business? Okay, so this is called as value of business, but this will be called as book value of business. Why book value? Because we are referring to the books of account, we are going to the balance sheet, and then we are taking the total of the assets, and then we will minus the liabilities out of it, so we will get net assets. That will be called as book value of the business. But this is the book value of the business. Now, when we are talking about value of business, there are certain other items as well. Here we are taking only the physical assets. This book value is referred to only related to physical assets of the company. So book value would be always related to physical assets and physical liabilities of the business. But when we are talking about business as a whole, there are certain other elements. That is called as, there would be some goodwill of each business. There are patents, rights, which will be called as intangibles. So when we are talking about the exact value of business, or when we are doing the assessment of the worth of a business, we should consider not only the book value of physical assets, but we should also consider the intangible assets. And of all of these intangible assets, the most important asset of intangible assets is the goodwill. Goodwill is an intangible asset which we should always consider when we are valuing the business. So what is the next thing? What is the need of value of share of business? And then we'll go to the next point. Why we need the valuation of business? If you want to see the value of the business, you can straight away go to the balance sheet, you can check the net assets of the company, you will calculate what is the value, book value of the business. But when you want to sell your business, sale of business, or when you are going to amalgamate with other company, amalgamation, merger, takeover, or liquidation. So all in this case, we need to go and do the assessment of the value of the business and arrive at the correct valuation, or arrive at the correct value of the business. So in all these cases, we are going to do the valuation. So when we are doing the valuation for all these cases, physical assets, we already know from the balance sheet what is the net asset, net physical asset available for this business. So the most important part when we are doing or going through any of these selling of the business or amalgamating, merger or takeover, most important part we need to work on is the valuation of goodwill. So how to value the goodwill? So Venerable sir has already explained what is goodwill and all, but we'll take one example to understand it better. What is goodwill, exactly what you mean by goodwill in the business, and how to, then we'll see how to calculate the business and then how to calculate the value of business once we calculate the goodwill. So we take a smaller example to understand the goodwill and the concept of valuation. Why we need to go and calculate goodwill before we calculate or do the valuation of a business. So let's, for example, there are let's say this is an example where we are having 5 sweet shop in the market. So these are sweet shop A, B, C, D, and E. All of them have invested rupees 50 lakh. So what is this investment? Is the net asset. So their book value is 50 lakhs. But that is called as net asset or capital employed. So all the assets minus external liabilities will give net asset, or that is also called as capital. So all of them have invested 50 lakhs in their business. Now we will see wants to enter into sweet shop business. So what we will do, we will assess all the shops which are available in the market and we will see what is the profit. Now from here you can see A is earning the highest profit whereas E is earning the lowest profit. So why A is earning highest profit? So there are certain things that are helping A to earn that profit. What is that? A is the established shop. Or you can say it is there for more than 10 years in the business. So it is the established shop. Second, it is having good reputation in the market. This sweet shop is having good reputation in the market because of their quality, for example. Quality or service. So they are having this advantage also, they are having good quality and service as compared to other ones. They are established ones, so they have established in the market for a long time. They have reputation. They have recognition in the market. They are having loyal customer base. What is loyal customer base? This customer will always go to shop A to purchase their sweets. So that is the reason they are enjoying all these benefits. So all these benefits, they are enjoying over the other shops in the market. So if you see, B is also doing well. So they are also having good, they are also established one, they are also having reputation, recognition, loyal customers. C, D, E. But if you see, A is the most earning shop in the market, which enjoying all these benefits for, because they are established in the market and all these other attributes are also applicable to them. So when they are getting some benefit because of all these characteristics which they are having, these benefits are what has goodwill. When you have established in the market, you are having reputation, good reputation, you are having recognition, you are having loyal customer base. This all will lead into earning more profit as compared to the competitor. So what it leads to? More profit over other customers. So if you go to the, now you can see that there are different shops. If you, your company XYZ wants to enter into sweet market, so you do the market study to find out that if you go and invest in the sweet shop market, your normal rate of return would be 10%. So you are expecting that you should earn 10%. Normal rate of return for this industry is 10%. So for example, you are going to invest 50 lakhs. So 10% is 5 lakh. Okay, so 5 lakh. So if you invest the same amount, 50 lakhs, which all these shopkeeper has invested, you are expecting that you will get 5 lakhs of profit. So that is called as normal rate of return. What is normal rate of return in the market? 10%, that is 5 lakhs. So what it suggests is if you go and invest 50 lakhs in the market in the and purchase one sweet shop, you are going to get 5 lakhs of income. So now, one by one, book value of all the sweet shops is rupees 50 lakh. Now you go and if you see, search for all the sweet shops, E is earning 4 lakh. So your XYZ company will pay 50 lakhs to purchase each shop. You will not pay because if you start your own sweet shop, then also you are getting 5 lakhs of income. Whereas E is earning only 4 lakhs. So you will not go there and pay 50 lakh to shopkeeper E. Why? Because if you invest 50 lakhs in each shop, you are going to get 4 lakhs rupees of income. Whereas if you start your own business, you are going to get 5 lakhs. So you will not consider E's option. Now D. D is earning 5 lakhs of rupees income, which is normal. He is earning normal profit. What is normal profit? Even any newcomer, new investor invest in the same market, same industry, they are also going to get the same return. So even if you start your own business, you are going to get 5 lakhs. So if you are going to purchase this business, instead of starting your own business, if you are going to purchase this business, how much you will pay? You will pay only 50 lakhs to him because the Even if you go to D or D comes to you to say this business, your offer price would be only 50 lakhs. Why 50 lakhs? Because your profit which D is earning is normal profit. Anybody can enter in the market and earn the same profit. So that is the reason whatever profit you are going to get, the same profit you are going to get from purchase of D's business. So for D's business, you will pay the book value. Book value of the business. Now when it comes to C, B and A. So now for example, if you see how much they are extra earning, if you calculate, C is earning 1 lakh rupees of extra income as compared to normal profit, B is earning 3 lakhs and A is earning 5 lakhs. This is called as extra profit over and above. Over and above your normal profit. They have invested 50 lakhs. The normal rate of return is 10%. So 10% anybody can expect from that kind of business. So 5 lakh is the expected profit or normal profit. But if you compare it with their actual profit, you will get they are earning some extra profit. So how much A is earning 5 lakh, 3 lakhs and 1 lakh. So when you go to these businesses to purchase their business. So for example, you go to business B. B is ready to sell his business to you. So when you go to him, you will compare, if you start your own business, 50 lakh, you invested 50 lakh, you are going to get 5 lakhs of income. But because you are purchasing B's business, they are already established in the market, they are enjoying all these benefits because of their loyal customer recognition, reputation in the business. So he will divert something extra. Over and above his book value of the business, which is 50 lakhs. And you will be also ready to pay him extra because he is already earning the earning good profit in the market and he is already established in the market. So with his name, with take his business and with his reputation in the market, you are going to earn some extra profit which is 3 lakhs. So currently he is earning 3 lakh rupees extra. So we can say that if we purchase the same business, we are also going to earn 3 lakh rupees of extra. So when you are getting 3 lakh rupees of extra income, what you will need to do? You will need to pay something extra to be, we will demand something extra from you over and above this book value of the business. So what is the book value of the business for B? It is 50 lakh. But will he sell his business for 50 lakhs? No. Why? Because he is already earning 8 lakhs of rupees of income. So if you want to take his business, he will surely demand something extra because of all these benefits he is enjoying in the market. So that extra which you are going to pay is called as goodwill. Why goodwill? Because this goodwill B has earned. You are getting this ready-made, all these benefits you are getting ready-made because of just purchasing the business of B. Once you enter in the business, you will not need to start your own business and go and establish your business in the business and earn the reputation. It is already done by B for you. So for that you will certainly ask something extra from you over and above this goodwill. So whatever extra, it is called as goodwill. So now this goodwill, so for example, that extra is coming as, for example, 15 lakhs. So 65 lakhs. So what you will do, instead of paying him 50 lakhs for his 50 lakhs of net asset, you are paying 65 lakhs. But when you compare this 65 lakhs with other business, for example, if you paid 50 lakhs to B, you are going to get no extra profit. You will get only normal profit. So to get some extra profit to earn the or to enjoy the benefits which B is currently enjoying in the market, you will pay something extra. That extra is called as goodwill. Now we know that whoever is earning some extra profit, we are going to pay, you will need to pay some extra value to purchase his business. So that extra, so where will we pay extra? Only when there is some extra profit. So when we are going to calculate the value of goodwill, now we are just assuming that it is coming as 15 lakhs. So what we are going to do in this topic is to find out this extra amount. What is the extra amount we should pay to purchase the business of any, to purchase any business in the market who is earning some extra profit. So that is called as valuation of goodwill. So this is the important part of this topic, valuation of goodwill. So in valuation of business, even though the topic name is valuation of business, what we are going to do judged by them because of their reputation in the market. So now valuation of goodwill. Now we know that we need to pay something extra to all the to whichever business we are purchasing, which is earning more profit in the business over and above average profit. So how to calculate it? Now there are different methods to calculate the value or to do the valuation of goodwill. We understood what is goodwill. We know that how to do. So now in this topic, we are just going to do the valuation. So there is no accounting books or accounting entries that we are going to pass. We are just going to do the valuation. So there are certain steps and calculations and simple working notes. We are going to take some steps, do some calculation, and prepare some working notes to arrive at the value of goodwill. So there is no preparation of accounts or books of account, or we are not going to pass any entries, even though it is a topic of financial accounting. We are just going to follow some steps, do some simple calculation, and prepare some working notes, and that is going to give you the value of the goodwill. So we will now see what are the methods of valuation of goodwill. What are the methods we should follow, or what are the methods there in the syllabus to do the valuation of the goodwill. So first is valuation of goodwill based on average profit. Then valuation of business based on super profit. And third one is valuation of business, goodwill on capitalization. Average profit, super profit, and capitalization of profit. So these are the methods we are going to learn in this topic to do the valuation of goodwill. How much extra we should pay to purchase the business which is earning extra profit in the market as compared to the normal profit which is expected from the same industry. So now what is average profit? So for example, here we are talking about B. He has earned 8 lakhs of profit. Rupees 8 lakh profit in the current year. So when we are talking about average profit method, what we are going to do, we are going to calculate the first average profit. How to calculate average profit? We will get past profit of this business. So now we are going to value this business because we want to purchase it. And when we purchase it, we are going to enjoy the benefits by purchasing this business in future. So in future we are going to enjoy the benefits, but to calculate the average profit, how PE is performing in the market, we need to go into past. We need to go in past and understand what is the profit earned by B in past years. So what we will do, we will get past years profit. So normally we will get 3 years or 5 years profit, past years, for example 3 years profit. So here you are into 2020, you want to see how much he has earned in past. You will go to maybe from 2015 or 2017, you will get his profit. Divide by number of years. Divide by number of years. So what you are doing? Past year profit, total, make total of all the past year's profit. So this past year's profit will be available in the question. This will be given in the question. What is the past profit of the business which you are going to, for which you are going to calculate the goodwill? So past year profit divided by number of years. Number of years, how much number of years? For example, you are taking past profit for 3 years. You will divide it by 3 years. It is for 5 years, you will divide it by 5 years. That will give you average profit. Average profit is equal to past year's profit divided by number of years. Now when you are calculating goodwill for the business, just by doing the average, we will not calculate the goodwill because this business we are purchasing for the future benefit. Future benefit. Now we are going to purchase business of B for some future benefits. Then here you are talking about past profit. So when once you calculate the average profit, you need to move and calculate the future maintainable profit. In current year, he has earned 8 lakhs, but for past years, his earning was not 8 lakhs, so the average is coming as 7 lakhs, for example. Now, what is future maintainable profit? How much you are going to maintain? Whether you are going to get the same amount of profit by purchasing his business, or there are some extraordinary elements that are added to this profit. So, for example, what you will do? Minus expenses no longer needs to be paid. Plus income
method, then super profit method and capitalization method. So
With that, we'll now move to the next once we get the future maintainable form. Now, first method is average profit method. Valuation of goodwill based on average profit. So, in average profit, what we assume is whatever future maintainable we are getting, we will just multiply that future maintainable profit by number of years of service. Okay, so future maintainable profit we will calculate with this stage. We will come to know what is the future maintainable profit. Number of years of purchase, this will be given in the question. Number of years of purchase will be always given in the question. So we'll just multiply that by number of years of purchase. For example, 3, 5, whatever is given in the question, we'll just multiply. So what this method means, we are going to get this future maintainable profit, that is, in future we are going to get whatever profit we are arrived at as future maintainable profit. Multiply by number of years of purchase means what? Because of B's name in the market, because of B's reputation in the market, because of B's recognition in the market, because of B's loyal customer base in the market, how many years we are going to continue getting this profit. So now we have purchased this business. Now the business will be handled by whichever company has purchased B's business. So because of B's business, because he is having established business, we should get 3 to 4 years benefit in the market. Beyond that, you need to establish your own customer base or your own reputation. So B has already established his reputation and recognition in the market. But how many years you can continue with that? Maximum 3 or 5 years. After that, because you are now going to run that business, after that you need to, if you get the reputation and recognition loyal customer base, it will be because of you, because you have already started running this business. So maximum how many years you can get benefit of B's name, that will be called as number of years of purchase. Number of years of purchase is because of this, then you are earning this future maintainable profit. How many years? It may be 3 years, 4 years, 5 years. So that depends upon question to question. And we are not going to calculate this. This will be available in the question. So whatever is given, we are just going to apply it. So once future maintainable profit calculated, multiplied by number of years of purchase will give you value of goodwill. So as per first method, what is the value of goodwill? Average profit method is equal to future maintainable profit into number of years of purchase. So goodwill is equal to future maintainable profit, which we are going to calculate. So this will be calculation. Number of years of purchase will be given in the question. You will just multiply it, you will get the goodwill as per method first. Now method number 2. So in method number 1, what we are going to consider is only future maintainable profit. Method number 2 is depend upon super profit. Valuation based on super profit. So how to calculate this? Now it is talking about super profit. We are arrived at, already we know how to calculate future maintainable profit. Now from future maintainable profit, how to arrive at super profit? So first we will see that. So we have calculated super future maintainable profit. Now we will calculate the normal profit from the industry. From which industry we are buying the business. So for this industry, what is the normal rate of return? So for example, future maintainable profit for B is coming as 8 lakh rupees. If you purchase the business of B, we are going to get rupees 8 lakh profit in future. Now we will see how much is the normal rate of return if we invest the money in the business of B. For example, it is given as 10%. Normal rate of return is given 10%. B's book value is 50 lakh. Or it is called as capital employed. Capital employed means what? How much capital B has invested to earn profit of 8 lakhs. So in our case, for example, it is 50 lakhs. The normal rate of return is 10%. So normal rate of return will be always given in the question. So we are not going to calculate it. This will be available in the question, normal rate of return. Now next is capital employed, and we are going to get normal profit. So how to calculate is equal to normal profit. Normal profit is equal to capital employed into normal rate of return. So now, as I said, normal rate of return would be given in the question. For now, we are considering capital employed for these businesses 50 lakh. So 50 lakh into 10% is equal to 5 lakh. What is this 5 lakh? It is normal profit. 5 lakh is the normal profit. So if you invested the same amount in the business, you will get 5 lakhs of rupees of normal profit. Whereas future maintainable profit is 8 lakhs. So future maintainable profit minus normal profit. Normal profit, how much is the normal profit? 5 lakhs. So whatever extra profit he is earning is called as super profit. What is super profit? Extra profit earned by any business because of the reputation, recognition in the market, that is called as, because of that business goodwill, is called as super profit. So straight away what it is saying, this super profit you are earning because of your goodwill. Because of your goodwill. So when you are purchasing this business, you will pay extra amount because of this super profit. Not future maintainable profit, but super profit. You are going one step ahead and you are calculating super profit, and on that super profit now you are going to value the goodwill, and you will pay that goodwill to purchase of these businesses. So now if you see how to calculate super profit, future maintainable profit you will calculate. We know how to calculate future maintainable profit. For normal profit, for calculation of normal profit, you will need capital employed of the business and normal rate of return. Normal rate of return will be given in the question. So this capital employed, again there is one calculation that we need to do. Capital employed we need to calculate to arrive at the normal profit. So what we are going to calculate now? Capital employed. How to calculate capital employed to arrive at the super profit? We know how to calculate future average profit, future maintainable profit. Now we see next working note, that is calculation of capital employed. So what is this capital employed when we talking about capital employed from goodwill perspective? So capital employed is how much money this business has invested to earn the profit. Which are profits? So for example here they are earning 8 lakhs rupees of profit. So how much investment that business has done to earn this 8 lakhs rupees of profit? So we can say it is equal to all the assets minus external liabilities. That will give you net assets. So what is that? All the assets minus external liabilities. That is called as net asset or capital employed. Now, while calculating this future maintainable profit, if you remember, we have only consider trading profit. Trading profit means what? When this business we are purchasing it for that business that we is doing. We are not purchasing it for whatever investment he has done. So we should not consider the investment for calculation of capital, because all investment is not earning the trading profit. All investment is earning the rate of return which is prevailing in the market for the investment, for whichever investment he has done. So investment is nothing to do with this business. Business is different, investment is different. So for that calculation of goodwill, we should not consider investment. Okay, when we are not considering investment, there is one more point that we need to consider. Investment, there are two types of investment. One is trading investment, business perspective, for the business only. For example, you are creating some depreciation fund or workmen's compensation fund. These investments are required to run your business. These are done or investments are made for your business purpose. So that is the reason it is called as trading business. Not trading business are you are invested, for example, in some shares, fixed deposit, or debentures of any other company. These are called as non-trading investment because those are not supporting your business. Those are done because you are having some extra surplus money, surplus fund. That's the reason you have made some investment. So these 8 lakh rupees you are not earning because of this. You are earning because of the assets and the trading investment. So that is the reason this investment, non-trading investment, we should not consider. Non-trading investment will not be considered while calculating capital employed. So what we will do? All the assets minus all the external liabilities minus non-trading investment will give you capital employed. Capital employed means how much capital you have or how much money you have invested to earn the profit. So that is called as capital employed. So in capital employed, there are few points you need to consider. First, net asset minus all the external liabilities minus investment. And while calculation or while taking the net asset value, there are other things that needs to be considered that we will see now. When we are adding the assets for capital employed, so if there is goodwill, if the goodwill is already there in the B's balance sheet, you should not consider it for calculation of capital employed for calculation of goodwill. So goodwill will not consider. Exclude goodwill, non-trading investment. This we will not consider. Then other assets and liabilities. Other assets and liabilities. For other assets, you will be having book value. For other assets and liabilities, you will be having book value in the balance sheet of B. When you are purchasing business of B, you will go and refer his balance sheet and you will get the book value of other assets and liabilities. But when you are purchasing the business, of B, you will straight away not consider the book value of the assets and liabilities.
So when
super profit method today is equal to instead of future maintainable profit, you will just say super profit. Super profit into number of years of purchase. So only difference is both the methods are same. Only in case of second method, super profit method, we are going one step further. We will calculate the normal profit. Based on that, we will calculate the super profit. Once we calculate super profit, it is simple super profit into number of years of purchase. So similar way, what is number of years of purchase? Because of his name in the market, we can still continue using his name and we can earn this super profit for next 3 to 5 years. So maximum it would be 5 years, but that will be available in the question again. So you need not worry about that. What is number of years of purchase? How many years we are going to get benefit using his name? After that, even if you get the super profit, it is because of you, not his name. So that is called as number of years of purchase. The super profit, number of years of purchase will be given in the question. Super profit, we know how to calculate. So we can calculate the goodwill. Okay. Okay, so now we have seen how to calculate the super profit and capital employed. Based on that, how to calculate the goodwill. So we will see one question from the book on calculation of goodwill using super profit. So this is the most important method for calculation of goodwill, and questions are expected in the exam to calculate the goodwill using the super profit method. So we will see one question from page number 211. Question number 2, purchase of super profit. So the balance sheet of Vishnu Limited is given. So from liability side we are having equity share capital, capital reserve, profit and loss, creditors, depreciation fund for land and building and machinery. On asset side, we have goodwill, land and building, machinery, stock, debtors, reserve for bad debts, cash and bank balance. Now the information is given, the company's business is to be purchased by Shiv Limited. You are required to value the goodwill and business of the company after taking into account the following information. So what we are going to do, we need to value the goodwill and business. So first we need to value the goodwill, and once goodwill is valued, we will go into value the business. So what is the information given? The adjustments are given. The reasonable return on capital employed in the class of business done by the company is 12%. So as I said, this information will be always given in the question, that is normal rate of return. Normal rate of return is given in the question as 12%. The company's average profit of the last 5 years after making provision for taxation at 50% amounted to ₹47,500. So here if you see, they already given the average profit. So we are not required to go and calculate the average profit. So average profit is given. How much it is given? 47,500. It is after tax. So average profit after tax is given 47,500. The present market value of land and building is 110,000. So what is this saying? They have revalued the land and building, and the new value is given in the question, that is 110,000. Original book value is given 95,000. The other assets are to be taken at the book value. So other assets, we are going to consider the book value as the fair value, and there is no revaluation for the other assets. The directors of Vishnu Limited, 2 in number, are to be appointed on the board of directors of Shiv Limited. The worth of their services is and will be in future 5,000 per annum for each of the 2 directors. So when we are purchasing Vishnu Limited, they are having 2 directors which we are going to appoint them in new company, that is Vishnu Limited, and we are going to pay 5,000 each for both of them. But no charge has been made regarding this against the profit of the Vishnu Limited. The goodwill of the business of Vishnu Limited is to be taken at 4 years purchase of super profit of the company. So what is that? It's saying we are going to calculate using super profit method. Number of years of now we know what is the average profit, what is the normal rate of return, what, how many years we have to consider to value the scooty. So this information is available. So now we are going to start calculating value of goodwill using the super profit method. So now we know what is the average profit before tax. Now we can adjust that profit to arrive at the future maintainable profit. So what was the adjustment given to calculate the future maintainable profit? Okay, if you go to the adjustment number 5, there they are saying the directors of Michelin Limited employee number are to be appointed on the board of directors of Michelin Limited. So we are going to appoint two directors from Michelin Limited, which we are going to purchase, and we are going to appoint them in new company, and each will get paid 5,000 per annum. So there are two directors we are going to. So this director remuneration is the extra expense. So whatever extra expense we are going to incur because of purchase of this business, we should be minus that from the average profit before whatever average profit we are getting. So there are two directors. 5,000 each we are going to pay, so 5,000 into 2 directors remuneration, so that is coming to 10,000 rupees. This is extra expense we are going to incur. So we will not going to receive this average profit as future maintainable profit, because if you consider that as average profit, still we need to pay 10,000 extra to 2 directors which we are going to appoint from the Michelin Limited. So how much is the future maintainable profit? 85,000. That will be called as future maintainable profit before tax. Future maintainable profit before tax. So now again we will calculate the tax on future maintainable profit. So there is no tax rate given for the future. So whatever tax rate is given in the question as current tax rate, we will consider the same as the future tax rate. So tax at the rate of 50%. So it is coming as 42,500. So once we calculate the tax, we will get future maintainable profit after tax. How much it is? 42,500. So we started with the average profit. Step number 1 is completed. We have calculated average profit. Step number 2, future maintainable profit. Calculation of future maintainable profit. So we calculated average profit before tax minus extra expenses. If there are some any extra profit is equal to future maintainable profit minus normal profit. Minus normal profit. That will give us super profit. So now we know future maintainable profit, we need to calculate normal profit. So how do we calculate normal profit? So step number 4, calculation of normal profit. How to calculate normal profit is equal to capital employed into normal rate of return. Now normal rate of return, we already know it is given in the question, is 12%. So now what we need to calculate is the capital employed. How to calculate capital employed? Again, you will just add all the assets. One by one, we will minus the external liabilities. But while adding the asset, as we discussed earlier, we need to follow some certain conditions for calculation of asset or calculation of valuation of asset. What is that? If there is goodwill given in the question, we should not consider it. Goodwill will not be considered for calculation of capital employed. So, goodwill will not consider it. If you go one by one, assets given in the question. We have goodwill 15,000. Goodwill we are not going to consider, so no value for goodwill. Then land and building. But first other assets we are going to consider the new value given in the question. So first one by one we will go and see if there is any valuation given for the asset. Land and building book value is 95,000. But if you see adjustment number 3, it is given the present market value of land and building is 1,10,000. So we will consider that as a value of land and building because it is given in the adjustment that there is valuation for land and building. So land and building is equal to 95,000. Sorry, 1,10,000, 95,000 is its book value. If new value is given in the adjustment, always consider that new value, don't consider the book value. Adjustment number 4, what it is saying, other assets are to be taken at their book value. So only the new value is given for land and building. Other assets we need to take the value given in the question, that is book value. So one by one we will go, machinery it is given 60,000. So just one by one we will add. Machinery 60,000, stock 57,500, debtors 49,000, cash and bank it is given 3,500. So total it is equal to 2,80,000. So this is our gross asset. We have considered land and building at new value in the question. Goodwill we have not considered. So that are the rules while calculating capital employed for valuation of goodwill. Okay, so total is coming to 2,80,000 minus all the external liabilities. Liabilities, what are the liabilities given in the question? Creditors 63,000. Now there is depreciation fund given, land and building and machinery total 22,500. So depreciation fund and if you see on the asset side there is reserve for bad debt. So when there is reserve given, you need to consider it as an external liability. It is 1,500. So either you can show debtors as 47,500 by minusing 1,500 from gross value, or you can show this RDD or the reserve for bad debt separately as 1,500 as a liability. So now take the total of all the liabilities, it is coming as 87,000. So gross asset minus external liabilities, it will give you the capital employed. How much it is? 2,80,000 minus 87,000, it is equal to So this is the capital employed. How we have calculated? Once again, we'll go through it. Assets, consider only, don't consider goodwill. Consider all the other assets at the new value given in the question. If the new value is not available, just consider the goodwill. So only land and building is given at new value, other we are considered as goodwill. Now we know what is, how much is the capital employed. It is equal to 1,90,000. So we are going to get the normal profit, capital employed into normal rate of return. So how much is the capital employed? Now we have calculated it. It is equal to 1,93,000. What is the normal rate of return given? 12% it is given in the question. 12% it is coming as 1,93,000 into 12%. 23,160. So what it is saying? If you invest the same amount, which Vishnu Limited has invested in the business, if you invest the same amount in today's date, you are going to get 23,160 rupees profit if you consider at normal rate of return. What is normal rate of return? When a new business starts its business in the industry, or if you enter in the industry, normal expected return is 12%. So you will get 23,160 rupees of income if you enter in the business using the same amount which Vishnu Limited has invested. How much he has invested? 1,93,000. So 23,160 you will be earning. So that is called as normal profit. Normal profit. Normal profit. We know normal profit. Now for calculation of super profit, what we need to know? Future maintainable profit, normal profit. Future maintainable profit we have calculated in step number 2. Normal profit we have calculated in step number 4. So now we have both things, amount. How much is the future maintainable profit? 42,500. Minus how much is the normal profit? 23,160. So we will get super profit. How much is the super profit? 19,340. The profit earned over and above the normal profit is called as super profit. Extra profit is called as super profit in this one. Okay, so now we know super profit. So next step is the simple calculation of goodwill using the super profit method. How to calculate the goodwill now? Step number 5, last step, the calculation of goodwill. Is equal to super profit into number of years of purchase. So is equal to how much is the super profit we have calculated? 19,340. 19,340 into number of years of purchase. It is given in the question. It is equal to 4 years. So 19,340 into 4 will give you the value of goodwill. So how much it is? It is equal to 77,360. Is our value of goodwill. So now we know how much is the value of goodwill. 77,360. So what we need to calculate in this question? We are calculating valuation of goodwill and business. So now Vishnu Limited is selling his business to Shiv Limited. So Shiv Limited is going to pay the value of business to Vishnu Limited. How much we should pay Shiv Limited? We have calculated the value of goodwill, now we will calculate the value of business. So value of business, calculation of value of business is simple. How to calculate? We already calculated net asset, capital employed. That is equal to net asset. We have already calculated 1,93,000 plus value of goodwill. How much is the value of goodwill? 77,360. That will give you value of business. because ship limited is getting net asset worth of this 1,93,000. Plus we have done the valuation of goodwill, which is 77,360. We should pay 77,360 extra to Vishnu Limited to purchase this business. So value of business is equal to net asset plus value of goodwill. So that will give you the value of business. So one important thing you need to understand here, for valuation of business, this net asset will include investment as well. While calculation of capital employed for goodwill, we have seen we should not consider the non-trading investment. But while calculation of valuation of doing the valuation of business, we should add net asset or capital employed calculated for calculation of goodwill. Plus we should add all the investment, not trading investment, then add valuation of goodwill, because investment also we are getting when we are purchasing the business of whatever business we are purchasing. So investment also we are getting, so that is the reason we need to consider investment as well. But for calculation of valuation of goodwill and calculation of capital employed for the purpose of goodwill, we should not consider non-trading investment, because we are not earning trading profit out of that investment. But for calculation of valuation of business, we should consider investment. So that is the difference for calculation of capital employed or calculation of net asset for the calculation of goodwill and for valuation of business. So this is how we should we will calculate or value the goodwill and business using super profit method. So this is how we are going to calculate super profit. I hope you understood this. And we'll now quickly see how to value the goodwill using capitalization method. So now we know how to value the goodwill using average profit method, super profit method. Now the last one is calculation of goodwill using the capitalization.
How much investment you need to make is equal to, in our case,
10 lakh rupees into 100 divided by 10 is equal to rupees 1 crore. So if you make the investment of rupees 1 crore, you will be earning rupees 10 lakh. So anyways, if you purchase this business, you are going to earn 10 lakh rupees of income. So what you do, instead of calculating going by net asset method, what you are doing, you are straight away giving rupees 1 crore to purchase this business, whichever business you are purchasing, which is generating rupees 10 lakh rupees of income in future. So what you are making sure, you are getting normal rate of return. Anyways, you invest in this industry, you are going to get 10%. So in this case also, you are getting 10%. 10 lakh rupees of income is expected in future. So for that, you need to make investment of rupees 1 crore. So now, what you will do? You will compare this. This will become your value of business. How much is the value of business? This business, because this business is generating 10 lakh rupees of income and the normal rate of return is 10% for the same industry, you can consider that to earn this 10 lakh rupees you need to invest rupees 1 crore. So the worth of this business is rupees 1 crore because it is earning at 10%, it is earning 10 lakh rupees of income. So now you know value of business is 1 crore. Now you will compare, now you will go and calculate the net asset of that business. Even though it is earning 10 lakh rupees of income, net asset of that business is, suppose for example it is 70 lakh. How to calculate net asset? Same method, all the assets minus liabilities at new value given in the question. So what is the difference? 30 lakh. So that will be treated as, or that will be called as value of goodwill. So what, basically what we are doing here, you are capitalizing the future maintainable profit. Once you capitalize, you come to know how much is the capital that is required to earn the future maintainable profit. Once you know how much is the capital required to earn that future maintainable profit, that becomes the value of that business, which is generating that income for you. Now, you will compare it with its net asset. How much is the actual net asset of that company? Net asset, for example, it is when it is lower than the actual value of the business, the difference is called as the goodwill. You are paying this goodwill because this business is already generating income for you, which is actually if you invest rupees 1 crore, then only you will get this business in the current situation. So that is called as value of goodwill using capitalization method. Now there is other method to calculate this goodwill. What we have done here, we have calculated value of business minus net asset, that is giving us value of goodwill. We can straight away also calculate goodwill. Goodwill using capitalization method. How to calculate? Value of goodwill is equal to super profit into 100 divided by normal rate of return. So what we will do? Once we get the super profit, so up to calculation of super profit, the stakes will remain same. So for example, super profit, it is coming as 1 lakh rupees into 100 divided by normal rate of return. In this case, for example, it is 10%, so 10. So it is equal to 10 lakh rupees. So what we are doing here, we are doing the same thing. We are earning, if we purchase the business, we are earning 1 lakh rupees of extra income, that is super profit. To earn that extra income, in current days, how much investment you need to make? If the normal rate of return is 10%, so you will need to make 10 lakh rupees of investment in the same industry to earn 1 lakh rupees of profit. So what that business is saying, I am already earning this profit for you. And if you go in the market, if you want to earn that profit, you need to make 10 lakh rupees of investment. So that investment becomes my goodwill. This is called as goodwill. Because this extra income is earning, and if you want to earn the same amount of income in the market, you need to invest 10 lakh rupees. So that 10 lakh rupees, anyways, you are getting that income, so that will be considered as goodwill, and you will pay that 10 lakh rupees to the seller of the business. So this is how you are going to calculate the goodwill using capitalization method. Simple, super how much capital you need to invest to earn that super profit. So that will be considered as goodwill. So now in our question number 2, they have asked us to calculate goodwill using capitalization method. So we have already calculated goodwill using super profit purchase method. Now we will see how to calculate goodwill using valuation of goodwill using super profit method, which is the most important method, and capitalization method, and then we move to valuation of shares. So that is also one part of this topic, important part, that is valuation of shares. So here we are talking about valuation of goodwill when the whole business is sold to other entity. Valuation of shares. Is the other part when one company wants to make investment in the other company and they want to purchase some stake in the other company by through purchase of shares. So we'll see how to do the valuation of shares and valuation of business using different methods. So we'll check that in the next lecture. So thank you students, and I hope you have understood this, how to value the goodwill. So important part of this topic is valuation of goodwill. Even though it is the topic name is valuation of business, the most important part we are going to do in this is valuation of goodwill. So once the valuation of goodwill is done, then valuation of business is simple. Just add the value of the goodwill into net assets. So that net asset also we are going to calculate for valuation of goodwill. So in next lecture we'll see valuation of shares, and then I will give you important notes related to this topic. What to consider and what not to consider for valuation of business and valuation of goodwill. So this question will carry 15 marks in the exam. You will get the question to value the goodwill, and based on that valuation of business. So thank you.